In this illustration, we'll discuss about time-varying temperature difference between bodies. We are given that two bodies of masses M1 and M2 with the specific heats S1 and S2 at absolute temperatures T1 and T2, where first one is higher than the other, are connected by a rod of length L and cross-sectional area A with conductivity K. We are required to find the temperature difference of bodies after time t, and we can neglect any heat loss to surrounding. Here if we see the situation which is given like this, there are two bodies of masses M1 and M2 connected by a rod of length L. Their temperatures can be considered as T1 and T2 at any time. So, in this situation, say, when dq amount of heat flows from M1 to M2, then its temperature will fall by dT1 and its temperature will increase by dT2. So, we can write, if dq heat flows from M1 to M2 at any instant in duration dt, then we can write the value of dq is equals to minus m1 s1 dt1. The same will be m2 s2 dt2. If its temperature increases due to this loss of heat, if its temperature decreases by dt1 and its temperature increases by dt2. So this one relation we are having, say, this equation 1. And if we talk about the rate of heat conduction at time t, is this dq by dt we can write as simply Ka T1 minus T2 divided by L. Now, in this situation, here value of dq we can substitute in terms of T1 minus T2. So, here we can write from equation 1, we can write from this relation d of T1 minus T2 is equals to minus of dq multiplied by 1 by m1 s1 plus 1 by m2 s2. You can rearrange these terms to get the value of d of T1 minus T2. And here we are getting dq in terms of these values. So from here we can see this dq by dt we can equate here. The value of dq is equals to, this is Ka T1 minus T2 divided by L. And we can equate it to negative of d of T1 minus T2 divided by this 1 by m1 s1 plus 1 by m2 s2. So, rearranging these terms, here we can see d of T1 minus T2 divided by T1 minus T2 is equal to this negative of 1 by m1 s1 plus 1 by m2 s2 multiplied by Ka by L multiplied by dt. So, this is dq by dt which we are calculating, and if we take this dt on this side, this is the value of dq which can be equated to this term. Here now we can integrate both these sides. If left side and right side are integrated as all these values are constant at t equals to 0, the temperature difference was given as T1 minus T2. And at a general time, if the temperature difference is delta T as a function of time, which we are required to calculate, this we can integrate and get it. This left hand side after integration becomes ln of T1 minus T2, for which we apply the limits from T1 minus T2 to delta T as a function of time. And this equals to minus Ka by L multiplied by 1 by M1 S1 plus 1 by M2 S2 multiplied by T. Now, if we simplify these terms, then here you can see on substituting the limit, this becomes ln of delta t by t1 naught minus t2 naught. And right hand side is same as minus k a t by l multiplied by 1 by m1 s1 plus 1 by m2 s2. So, taking anti-log on the right hand side, left hand side, this becomes directly we are getting delta t as a function of time can be written as t1 naught minus t2 naught multiplied by e to power, the term is minus k a t by l 1 by m1 s1 plus 1 by m2 s2. So, this is the final result of this problem, the temperature difference of the bodies as a function of time.